Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. She's been a public speaker and HIV/AIDS activist since age 6. And many of us remember seeing her on The Oprah Winfrey Show when, at age 11, she shared the riveting story about her fight with full-blown AIDS.
Now 34 years old, healthy and hopeful, she continues to educate and advocate for those fighting the disease. Yes. Please welcome Hydea Broadbent. Yes. How are you?
Pretty lady.
Like a superstar. Like, yes. I've seen you my entire life. It's so, we're so glad to have you here. Sister Circle Live.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So let's jump right into it. Mm-hmm. Born with HIV, abandoned by your birth parents, adopted soon after, you were officially diagnosed with HIV advancement at age 3. Mm-hmm. Doctor said you wouldn't even live to see 5. Now you're 34 years old. How did you decide to continue to live in your now?
As an adult, it was hard. I'm not gonna cry.
It's all right.
I battled depression. So there's been stages of life where I've had to keep rechecking in, okay, to find my inspiration, to find my strength. It comes from God, first of all, my family, mm-hmm, my sister, Patricia, Zoe, my mom. My family as a unit keeps me going. And also my love for my community.
Yes.
To know what we know about HIV and to know that it's preventable, it gives me a little bit of anger, and that anger gets me out the bed to say, I want to spread awareness and I want to let people know that we have all the tools to eradicate this disease.
Yes, mm-hmm, yes.
You are a walking, talking angel and blessing from God. And throughout the course of your work in trying to create awareness about HIV and AIDS, what is the biggest misconception that you faced in your fight?
There's so many. Yesterday somebody asked me on Instagram, can you get HIV from kissing? You're kissing babies. If you watch my Instagram, I'm always around kids and I'm always kissing babies. So would I really kiss a baby if I could pass on HIV? A misconception is that we can't date, that we can't continue to live life. I can have a child without passing HIV on to my child.
Wow.
But that's because I know my status and I would take the steps to get in treatment and care. They assume that anyone that I'm dating is HIV positive. When all of my serious relationships, the men have been HIV negative before they entered and after they left the relationship.
Wow.
So there is life after a positive test result, mm-hmm, but it's about making sure you're taking the proper steps to be safe.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about your dating life and how that is and what you have to say when meeting someone. Mm-hmm. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, dating for me, I've just decided that I'm ready to start dating again. You know, I've been focusing on my goals and my family, and so I'm like, I want companionship. And it is hard. It's like, when do you disclose? Mm-hmm. Do I disclose on the third date? Do I have to worry about if I'm sitting in the car with a young man and he freaks out, does he have a gun? Is he going to want to kill me because he's not educated?
Mm-hmm.
We've had instances where people have disclosed their status and been attacked. A lot of people say, you should tell immediately. But when do I get to feel you out, to see your aura, to see if you're worth the reaction, if I want to deal with that?
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot that goes into it.
Right.
Yeah. And based on even the Instagram post that you have, what has been the misstep as far as the criminalization laws?
Mm-hmm.
Because
mm-hmm,
I know that they're outdated.
Right.
So can you kind of clarify what has been the amendments of these laws that are outdated?
So we have a fabulous group of activists all over the country who are working. These criminalization laws are 20 years or older.
Mm.
And so some of them are, if I spit on you, we shouldn't be spitting on anybody.
Right.
But you can be tried for attempted murder or tried for a felony. We
it's
know
ridiculous.
That HIV is not transmitted through spit.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to go back and reshape. California went where it was a felony. Now you can be tried as a misdemeanor for not disclosing. We know that this is not the death sentence that it once was.
Right.
So we are penalizing people and scaring people who don't want to then disclose. So we need to make sure it's not only about somebody who's HIV negative, but it's also about creating a safe space for somebody who's HIV positive to disclose.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. So there's a quote that you stated, with all that we know about the virus, it's clear to me that contracting HIV/AIDS today is a choice, and we can't allow anyone the power to make that choice for us. What exactly did you mean by that, and how can we curb this becoming an epidemic, especially for black women?
Yeah, because I've gotten in trouble for that statement. I don't think we purposely or knowingly go out and try to contract HIV, but what I say is we are engaging in behaviors or activities that might put us at risk when we're not asking the question. A lot of people put a lot of, it's all the responsibility is on me as somebody who's positive to disclose, to inform. But what about the individual? Are you asking those questions?
Right.
Because it's your health and it's your life.
Mm-hmm.
So why are you not asking your sexual partner about staying safe? A lot of men will come to me and say, I would never date a woman who's HIV positive. And I'm like, well, I could pretty much keep you safe, but go ahead, boo, don't date me.
Mm-hmm.
But yet you go out and, excuse my French, raw dog a woman you know nothing about and put yourself at risk.
Anyway.
For anything.
Right.
So it's about dual responsibility.
Wow.
Mm, my God.
Oh my goodness.
Sitting here as this beacon of hope, what is one thing that you can tell young women, young black women who have, who are dealing with HIV or who suffer from HIV, not even suffer, I can't even say suffer anymore,
right.
because
living
it's not
with,
suffering,
right.
living with HIV or AIDS, what is something positive that you can tell them on how to get through their grief that you've done to become this person that you are?
First and foremost, what I want to say is I'm not perfect. I have my faults. But one of the things that I do not allow HIV to stop me at anything, not when it's approaching a man, not when it's knowing I could rock them shoes. You have to continue to live life. There's so many people, and life is hard. It's in a struggle. Living with HIV is not easy. I'm not going to say that it is, but you have to keep going. You have to just live life.
Yes.
And if somebody has something negative to say, oh, well, at least they talking about you, baby.
Right.
Like, I don't know.
Right.
Use your life for a positive.
Yes. Yes.
And the best way that I know how to educate people and inspire people is simply to live. And that's what I want to accomplish. I want to show the different stories of women and young girls and what we can accomplish and
yes,
do.
Yes, and you have done that beautifully well.
Thank
you so much for being here and sharing your story and continuing to live in this light. We love you so much. For more information about all the advocacy work Hadiya is doing, you can follow her on social media at Hadiya Broadbent.
And next up, R&B singer Glenn Jones drops by to chat about his new single, Love by Design.
Thank you, Hadiya.
Yay.